Greetings. It is critical, as we follow the Son of God, to humbly love the truth. In a reply to Anwar nearly 2 months ago, I replied in haste. I replied in impatience. I ranted, and I was wrong on an assertion I made. As I have said before, and will say again, no doubt, my salvation, thankfully, does not rest on my perfection. Let's take a look at this earth-shattering failure. Anwar had raised as an issue someone named Diotrephes. I can't find his original post, but along the lines of, what about Diotrephes, and talking about his rejection of the authority of the Bible. I replied with the following, which Anwar has captured in his treasure trove of refutations. My post. It's probably too small to read. I did not miss it, brother. So he had asked why I didn't respond to his really long post. I ignored it because they are not relevant questions. You know the standard grocery list. The Word of God is clear, and Islam denies the Word of God. This is the same behavior of Satan in the Garden of Eden when he deceived Eve with, "Has God said?" John the Apostle knew Jesus personally and was inspired by the Holy Spirit to reveal Jesus as the Word of God. Maybe the questions you should ask are, who is Diotrephes? What's his background? Why are his words lost to the sands of time? Why did the opinion of Diotrephes not matter? No mention of Diotrephes by any scriptures or any prophets ever. Those are the lines that he highlighted in red underline. You see, brother, you do not judge clearly because you have an agenda. So here I flame away and state, no mention of Diotrephes by any scriptures or any prophets ever. And honestly, if Anwar goes to hell because I did not bother with due diligence, I will feel devastated, humiliated when I review this before God on that day. Anwar was right about this one point. Someone named Diotrephes was mentioned in one verse of the Bible. In a subsequent exchange, I have admitted as much and reviewed the verses in question. Even though mention of this man has no doctrinal impact, I do not want to excuse my arrogance in shooting off my words without proper research. Now let's look at the mention of Diotrephes. My response to Anwar. Fair enough, on that one point regarding a person mentioned in one verse in the New Testament, you were correct and I was wrong. I did not remember Diotrephes because the mention is not significant to doctrine or the authority of the Word of God. That does not refute the content of any video. He replied, if another church isn't accepting the author of John's authority, I would say that's significant. The author of John's first response was an ad hom, a telling sign. Ad hom is ad hominem attack. It is important to understand the nature of misunderstanding by those who follow Muhammad's religion. As demonstrated here, Anwar's reading of this snippet, taken out of context, implies to him the church rejects John's letter. We shall see that is not the correct reading. Here is my reply. Not so. It is critical to respect God and read the context. 3 John 1:1. The elder to the beloved Gaius, whom I love in truth. Beloved, I pray that in all respects you may prosper and be in good health just as your soul prospers. For I was very glad when brethren came and testified to your truth, that is, how you are walking in truth. I have no greater joy than this to hear my children walking in the truth. Beloved, you are acting faithfully in whatever you accomplish for the brethren, and especially when they are strangers. And they have testified to your love before the church. You will do well to send them on their way in a manner worthy of God. For they went out for the sake of the name, accepting nothing from the Gentiles. Therefore we ought to support such men, so that we may be fellow workers with the truth. I wrote something to the church, But Diotrephes, who loves to be first among them, does not accept what we say. For this reason, if I come, I will call attention to his deeds which he does, unjustly accusing us with wicked words. And not satisfied with this, he himself does not receive the brethren either, and he forbids those who desire to do so, and puts them out of the church. Beloved, do not imitate what is evil, but what is good. The one who does good is of God, the one who does evil has not seen God. Demetrius has received a good testimony from everyone, and from the truth itself. And we add our testimony, and you know that our testimony is true. That does not indicate a rejection by the church, but only by this one individual. This person also did not receive other brethren in the church. I continue to learn, and from this I take away the following. Love the truth, and even knowing the truth, remain humble. There is no good reason for a hasty answer, which may be uncertain. Always be a good Berean and know what the Word of God says. And never fear admitting when you are wrong and make a mistake. 1 John 1:9. If we confess our sins, He is faithful and righteous to forgive us our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.